left.
Rada?
Do you know what this means, man? You're not getting your delivery of potatoes?
No, worse than that.
Your wife is gonna kill you when she finds out you spent all the money?
Even worse than that.
Even worse than... I give up, what?
No money means no animation.
No more money means no more animation. But often, money isn't always the case in cancellations. I'm Renuri, and I'm here with 5 canceled shows that ended way too early. Hey guys, so before today's video starts, I want to go ahead and ask you to like and subscribe. It means a lot to me and it helps with my engagement, and it also helps me grow as a channel and helps me produce more good content and get an accurate view of what you guys as the community want. Also, I know it's super corny, but I want to say a big thank you to those of you who watched and liked my recent videos upon my debut. It means a lot to me and my engagement. Whether good or bad, it does help my channel out. I'm super excited to see where this community is at in a year's time. All right, so without further ado, let's get into it. Number 5, The Marvelous Misadventures of Flapjack. We all know Flapjack. You know, the show that feels like it just aired yesterday, but a fever dream all at the same time. Yeah, that one. For those of you that aren't familiar, let me school you, cause this was my shit, and I just recently rewatched the series for like the 18,000th time. The Marvelous Misadventures of Flapjack was a show that aired on Cartoon Network on June 5th, 2008. The show revolved around a young boy by the name of Flapjack, a boy hungry for adventure, his captain, Knuckles, an old sailor whose background isn't really known, and a whale that acts as the young boy's maternal figure and home? Yeah, mail must suck for them. The show aired for 3 seasons, and in the mix had several specials, and even was included in Cartoon Network's mainstream advertising, as well as video game roster from Fusion Fall to Super Punch Time Explosion, which I have mixed feelings about my damn self. The show featured a lot of mixed media, and had such a dark tone to it that you ended up kind of desensitized to it, in a good way, if that makes sense. It made you think outside the normal taste that you usually prefer when watching a cartoon, between these shots of dark, gritty content and flashes of bright candy lace stills. Why was this show canceled? So y'all, this show fell victim to Cartoon Network hell. That's an era of Cartoon Network that I like to call it, at least. The show ended because Cartoon Network essentially felt like it didn't match their young, male-oriented lineup, which at the time was dubbed Cartoon Network Real, and included shows like Dude, What Would Happen, and Destroy, Build, Destroy, which I don't recall anybody liking, to be honest. While Flapjack and Knuckles never did technically meet their dreams of visiting Candied Island, Flapjack kinda did in the episode Over the Moon. When the moon's gravity was down, he spit towards Candied Island, and when the gravity reversed, he got to taste the island. While I personally was bummed out about the cancellation, it was a blessing in disguise, simply put, because the cancellation of this show spawned 2 beloved shows that saw their ends accordingly, Adventure Time and Regular Show. Number 4, Aqua Teen Hunger Force. So if you're an adult animation junkie like myself, you know this show. An OG in the dark humor game, and one of Adult Swim's longest running shows, Aqua Teen Hunger Force is a dark adult comedy show that features fast food items living in South Jersey that kind of varies in plot. It's said that the show spawned because of a rejected Space Ghost episode, which later got repitched as an entire series, which I think is pretty kick-ass in its own right. The show itself saw a variation of different names for each season, and lasted a good 11 seasons. Damn, 11 seasons on Adult Swim. The show eventually was canceled by Adult Swim in 2015, simply because they didn't feel like investing in it anymore. They even went as far as to tell the creators that it had nothing to do with budget or fan ratings, because as far as those, they were rich in both areas. The show itself has been said to have been pretty cheap to produce, but alas, the show's creator said during this time, there have been no plans to revive the series, but in 2017, during a bump by Adult Swim, one of them read, "Why don't you make more episodes of Aqua Teen?" To which Adult Swim replied, "We might." I'm sorry, y'all. This is what gets me. Adult Swim is the company I am striving to work for, simply because they are the trolls of all trolls. Now, while fans may have thought that Aqua Teen was canceled, the show has come back on many different occasions, and now Adult Swim has started airing an all-new mini web series titled Aqua Teen Hunger Force Aqua Dunk Side Pieces in April of 2022. If you are or even were a fan of the classic Aqua Teen Hunger Force, I highly advise you give these fun shorts a watch. They had me deceased, bruh. Number 3, Final Space. This motherfucking hurts my heart and soul to put in this video, and that's real talk. I never felt so helpless, but I'ma do you right, Olin Rogers. I'ma do you right. The show is an adult animation that features a guy named Gary Goodspeed who has been sentenced to a 5-year sentence aboard a ship named the Galaxy One. Throughout the series, viewers are introduced to fun, memorable characters, and I even cried a bit during the show, and that literally never happens for me. The show unfortunately was canceled by TBS, who at the time went through several mergers, which if you don't know anything about animation or TV in general, it makes it very hard on everyone production-wise as far as continuity that's secured at least. Final Space did survive one merger, but amid the pandemic, it was announced in September 2021 by the show's creator that the series would officially come to an end. It's worth mentioning that he did say he is hoping for some sort of hour-long special that would wrap things up and tie loose ends up for us fans, but that was a year ago sometime. This year, Olin Rogers showed us a screenshot of his messages to an exec at Warner about pitching a potential hour-long special, to which they told him it's not a fool's dream, which gives us fans some hope, but doesn't mean we're quite in the clear yet. Listen, Olin, you do whatever you gotta do to get the show back on. All I gotta say to WB, Warner Bros, whatever y'all wanna go by, Turner, whatever y'all want to go by, if I don't see more of my husband Lil Cotto, y'all gonna have to knuck if y'all buck. Number 2, Teen Titans! Teen Titans. I'm not even about to trip and introduce this one. I'll simply put it like this. If you don't know who the Teen Titans are by now, I wanna live wherever you live, period. These mother truckers have been gracing our screens for 20 years now, and since then have received several spin-offs, movies, features, you name it. But the thing that's most memorable for us OG Titan fans is a series cancellation. The show initially ran for 5 seasons that began in 2003. During these seasons, they actually kicked up ratings for Cartoon Network, and part of it simply was because of DC's blessing behind the series. The series introduced us to romance, betrayal, comedy, and a bit of darker themes as well. But all good things do come to an end, and for this series, it wasn't spared. In 2006, and 66 episodes later, the show was announced as canceled. Y'all, I had to go back and re-record this because they really thought that they were slick. They made the movie that came out a year after the series ended, the official end, which is crappy because it didn't even really feel like an end. I mean, sure, it tied up some plot, you know, some type of strings that were hanging, but as for us real fans, it wasn't ending confirmation. Number 1, Thundercats. Thundercats captured the heart of many back when it first aired in 1985 and went on to become a household name in terms of animation for its time. Back in the early 2000s, you had to have an actual reputation, believe it or not, to make it to the reboot industry or the classic primetime network switcheroo. This happened to be the case for Thundercats, and the show ended up with a reboot on Cartoon Network in 2011 and scored high ratings almost immediately with critics and fans even of the original despite its new gritty and dark undertones. So the question we bother is, why was this show canceled? The show originally was planned to air for 56 episodes over the course of 2 seasons, but Cartoon Network pulled the plug on the show 1 season and 26 episodes in. And while the show was initially said to be on hiatus in 2012 upon ceasing to air, it was announced by the show's creator in early 2013 that the show was in fact canceled. Now y'all, I love y'all, cause your boy had to dig for this information. So apparently Cartoon Network put Thundercats in a bad time slot of 8:30 PM, and I'ma tell y'all, I'm gonna be the one to tell y'all. That's Adult Swim hours, B. To build upon that a bit more, Thundercats actually did end up playing through Toonami in the form of reruns on Adult Swim, so I guess that's something. The creator did end up revealing a source full of missing storylines and plot holes for the public fandom. If you're a Thundercat fan who misses the show, no, not the new one. Jesus. I will include the creator's reveals in the description below. So this originally was gonna be a video titled 5 Cancelled Shows and 5 That Lasted Way Too Long, but it's Friday, y'all, and I'm trying to game into my eyeballs cataract. If you liked today's video, be sure to give me a like and subscribe, and stay tuned for part 2 of today's video. Peace out, urinators. Love y'all.